everybody, and welcome back to Relax My Dog. Now today's video is sort of like an add-on to last week's video, as last week we spoke about hypoallergenic big dogs. Today we're going to be talking about the smaller dog breeds that are also hypoallergenic. Now, as I also mentioned in the previous video, it is very, very difficult to tell if a dog is hypoallergenic because there's sort of like a spectrum. No dog can be 100% hypoallergenic, and some of these breeds have sort of grooming needs, which basically means that this needs to be done to them to make sure they are as hypoallergenic as possible, especially if you do have allergies, obviously. But like I say, last week we spoke about the big dog breeds. Today we're going to be talking about the small dog breeds. But before we do get started, definitely do go down below to the comments and let me know, do you know any hypoallergenic small dog breeds? Is your dog hypoallergenic? Let me know it down below in the comments. But let's just get started. Now, the first dog breed that is hypoallergenic, I feel like I'm going to get sick of saying that word after these two videos, and our first dog breed is a Bichon Frise. Now, a Bichon Frise is very, very similar to the likes of a poodle. They have very, very similar fur, meaning they are very, very similar in terms of hypoallergenicness with a poodle, because they both have that sort of same fur and that curled coat. And because of this style of fur, it's harder for that dander to escape, and it means that they don't molt as much as well. And like I say, this dog breed, it does actually need to be regularly groomed, so it is something that you definitely need to keep on top of, which can be quite a costly thing to keep on top of. But I'm sure if you do have allergies, you will do anything to be able to have a pet but to also not be allergic to it as well. Now, our second dog breed is either a cane or a corn terrier. I can't remember how you pronounce it, but it's basically like the terrier that was on The Wizard of Oz, Toto. Now, the cane or corn terrier is one of the oldest dog breeds in terms of the terriers, and their coat is known to be like a non-shedding coat, which is good for people that are allergic to dogs. But again, this isn't like 100% across the board. As I mentioned in our previous video, definitely do get into contact with the dog breeder because they will be able to give you a little bit more information on that. Now, the third one is quite a popular one again, and this is the Chinese crested dog. Now, if you've seen this dog before, there are actually two different types. There's a hairless one, and then there's also one that has hair. I have only ever really, really seen the hairless one, and that is the one that is mostly hypoallergenic, as you can probably imagine, because it doesn't have a lot of hair, as you can probably get that from the name, as it's known as the hairless dog. And even though some of this dog breed don't have hair, it is important that you do brush the bits of dog that does have hair on it, so just be aware of that. And obviously, like I say, there is also a Chinese crested dog that does have hair as well. Number four is a miniature schnauzer. Now, miniature schnauzers are so cute. Now, a miniature schnauzer doesn't actually molt, and they are considered to be hypoallergenic. However, this sort of dog does require to be groomed every 5 to 8 weeks, meaning that it can be quite a high maintenance dog. But obviously, like I say, if you're allergic, you will do anything to have a dog, and whatever it costs. And then our last dog breed, which is number five, is a Maltese. A Maltese is such a cute dog. They're little white fluff balls, basically. Really, really adorable. Now, as you can probably imagine, these dogs are originally from Maltese, and these hardly ever shred as well, so perfect for if you have allergies. And that is it for this week's video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment down below, and also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, don't forget to enter our t-shirt giveaway. They just look like this. All you need to do to win your very own t-shirt is pop over to Instagram, post a picture of your dog, and tag us at @thatsmydog, and you have entered. It really is that simple. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and me and Milo here. We'll see you all next week for next week's video. Bye.